holding someone accountable is something you do for them. It's not something you do to them. It's something you do for them. Holding someone accountable is the best gift that you can give someone. It doesn't matter if it's someone on your team, if it's your spouse, if it's your children. Holding someone accountable is the highest form of love and care that we can demonstrate. Because ultimately you're saying, I know you're better than this. I know you're capable of more than what you're showing me right now. And because I care about you and I care about us so much, I'm not gonna let you slide. I'm gonna stay on you until you perform to the level that everyone in this room knows you're capable of. Now, I mentioned before that we wanna eradicate complaining, blaming others, and making excuses. This is usually when it will come out initially, because as human beings, we can often be defensive. It's natural for me to hold you to an incredibly high standard, and your default is to make an excuse, to blame someone else, or to complain about what I'm doing. The sooner we can get someone on our team to move past that phase and to the point where they say, you know what, he's right. I am capable of more, and I owe it to my teammates to give them more, so I got you. The quicker we can move to that phase, the better off we'll be. And we have to realize that we have to look in the mirror with this as well. We have to be able to take the same medicine. That even if you are sitting on the very top of the org chart, you still have to allow yourself, have the vulnerability and humility to allow everyone else to hold you accountable. You cannot lead from an ivory tower. They need to understand that you will hold yourself to the same standards of excellence and habits that you're asking them to. Because the quickest way to undermine yourself as a leader is to have behavior that is not in alignment with what you're asking everyone else to do. If you're going to talk the talk, you absolutely have to walk the walk. Now, most of us are incredibly familiar with what's called vertical accountability, which means you're in charge, you tell everyone underneath you what to do, and they have to do it. That's mediocre at best. The best organizations in the world also have horizontal accountability, which means I don't even need to be the first one to tell you to raise your performance, because your teammates next to you care so much about you and care so much about us, they've already told you. When you can create an atmosphere through love, grace, and compassion where everyone is holding everyone else accountable, now you have something really, really, really special. What happens in most organizations, I hold you accountable, you deflect or blame or complain or make excuses, then you go bellyache to these folks and they all jump in and become energy vampires as well. And they say, oh yeah, and now all of a sudden you guys have created this cancer inside of our organization that we simply can't have. So we need to all make sure that we can look ourselves in the mirror and look every single team member in the mirror and say, I'm gonna hold you accountable to the highest standards because I care about you and I care about us.